you miss me?
Filled up with doubt. I don't know who you think you are, but before the night is through, I wanna do bad things with you. I'm the kind to sit up in his room.
Hey guys, welcome to my newest video, DVD update for today, June 1st. If I look a little awkward, it's I've got a little bit of a neck injury. Not fun, so that's why I look like I'm decrepit. Been waiting a while, waiting for the DVD to grow, because I only had like 4 in the last couple of weeks, and I bought 6 today, so it warrants a video. Okay, first off, I picked up season 2 of Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Turn down the music a little bit. Because like I said, I'm going to get these now since they are so, see what I mean, so cheap, like $19.99. So yeah, there we go. And I might get some looks at this, but this was a childhood favorite, and I had to grab it because it was on sale from $35.99 to $11.99, and that is season 1 of The Muppet Show. It's The Muppet Show, people. It warrants to buy very quickly in my book. That made no sense, but I'm on Valium right now. Got this from the Disney Rewards program. I liked it when it first came out. I haven't seen it since, but it should still live up, and that's the remake to Freaky Friday. Yeah, I liked this the first time it came out. I don't remember too much, but I'll give it another shot. And finally, I've been wanting to get this for a while, but it's been too much money. Because it is a Disney Pixar film I like, but it didn't warrant the spending of $29.99 or more. And I got it used for $13.99, and that was Disney Pixar's Cars. And it's the same as with the Bug's Life. I'd love to get that, but I haven't seen that since 1998, so I don't really want to spend the $36.99 for it. So yeah, that's why I got this. These are the ones I got today. This is the Steven Seagal triple pack with Fire Down Below, Out for Justice, and On Deadly Ground. I think the only bummer is they're all full screen, but at $6.99, do you think I'm gonna bitch? Not really. And this is one I've been wanting to pick up for a long time, but it was the Evil Snapper case. And even worse is full screen. And version is and I actually think this is full screen. Shit! But $9.99 forever young. Standard version, this one has been modified. Oh, fuck it, it's the full screen. Damn it! But you know what, I've been putting it off for too long. It's a movie I like, so screw it. And the next one, I picked up a double feature with Kids and Rules of Attraction. Now, I hate Rules of Attraction with a passion, but I really like Kids, but not enough to pay over $20 for the DVD, for just Kids. I think that's the lowest I've seen it, and the highest I've seen it is actually $32.99, but, you know, $5, I think I can handle it. And of course, gee, I wonder what I bought today. Went to where I work, because I had coupons, and like I had on my debit card $20 worth of points, but for some reason they didn't get either of these two films, so I had to go to Best Buy, which didn't bother me too much. That of course is the first one up is the Blu-ray to Alice in Wonderland, I haven't seen this, but I've heard nothing but good things about it, so I hope it lives up. But yeah, I basically loved everything Tim Burton has done, so I'm pretty sure I like this. And my friend actually grabbed this for me and said, here's an early birthday present for you, and it's Doctor Who, Curse of Peladon, I think that's how I pronounce it. I was going to get the box set of this from the UK, but, because it has two stories, but they're not together. Like, this is story 61, and the other one is story 68, and I don't want to, like, take them out of the box, so I was just getting them here. So, but almost every other Doctor Who classic will be coming from the UK, as I said. So, yeah, another one for the classic Doctor Who collection. And lastly, of course, I wanted this more than I wanted Alice in Wonderland. Like, don't get me wrong, I want to see Alice, but this is what I wanted to see more. And that, of course, is the Blu-ray for The Wolfman. This is the Best Buy edition, where I guess it comes with 30 extra minutes of special features. And you get the unrated and theatrical cut, and the Blu-ray exclusives are two alternate endings. So I think out of those two, Alice and this is what I am looking forward to the most. So, yeah. And just do a quick, small Doctor Who update, because I got two more books to add to my book, my ever-going and growing book collection of Doctor Who Ghosts of India. And I did pick up one of the 11th Doctor stories, and that is Apollo 13. You can tell how they changed the books, but I don't care. I've read three of these already, and I find them very enjoyable. So, I do have some more new Who stuff I got, but I'll just show these for now. Okay, so that's it for this update. And I noticed I finally have broke the 300 subscribers, so thank you very much, everybody, for subscribing. I know 300 isn't a lot, but to me it basically is. So yeah, I'm on Valium right now, and it's starting to make me sleepy, so I think I'm just going to go hit the hay. Hopefully my neck feels better. So, I hope you guys have a good week. Watch shitload of movies, and of course, as always, rate, comment, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.